Over 60 years ago, humans had barely to visit space. Yet, 10 years later, humanity had already flown and returned from the moon, not only flying there 9 times, but landing 6 of those on the lunar surface. Yet, we haven't been able to go back to the moon in the past 50 years. Why? Who is to blame? We have to ask the bureaucracy from the United States in the 70s. Richard Nixon? Politics? Public interest, the Vietnam War, NASA, and especially the Space Shuttle. Having flown many rockets between 1957 until the end of the Apollo flights to the moon, including the Skylab missions, humanity had evolved from a basic technology set to being able to reach to another solar system satellite. However, our exploration outside of what's called low Earth orbit was halted abruptly due to funding in favor of a more economically and reusable system to reach orbit, instead of using the very expensive rockets that had been used in the past. As we know now, this didn't work out to be, as the Space Shuttle was as expensive as one of these rocket launches. Let's stop there for a second. In paper, the Space Shuttle sounds like a great plan, especially as it would have had a fast turnover between takeoffs and landings. However, this wasn't the case, as it took many months to refurbish just one shuttle. This is when you see that a government-run operation is not in the best interest of human exploration. In a short span of 14 years, from the launch of the Soviet satellite Sputnik to the first lunar landing, humanity had evolved from what it could have not done previously. However, with many factors, including budget cost, a plan to make a space shuttle was the most feasible option in the 70s, as it was presented to President Nixon as the vehicle that would pave the way to the future. Obviously, now we can know what went wrong. We could have kept growing, but humanity drifted away from what could have been possibly by then a lunar base. Instead, NASA focused on reusability and lowering costs. The Space Shuttle program doomed us for many decades to come. The representation of abandoning the exploration of deep space to focus on low Earth orbit just blows my mind personally. The program ran for almost 30 years. 30 years that humanity could have advanced towards reaching Mars, continuous flights to the moon, a permanent base there, or who knows what else, we could have been already by Jupiter maybe. In the end, after plus 30 years of the shuttle existence, we achieved small feats, such as in-orbit experiments, the Hubble telescope, and the construction of the ISS. All of these could have been achieved while having normal rocket flights, and not narrowly stranding ourselves to only low Earth orbit flights. The Space Shuttle could have been one of the most pivotal points in human exploration, if it would have worked the way it was planned to do. Instead, we lost 2 of the 5 shuttles. That means 40% of the fleet was lost, or an efficiency of 1 flight failure per 67 flights. That's a very high number, considering normal aviation has at least 100,000 flights a day. And how many times do you hear about an accident happening? But nowadays, we see that SpaceX has been a pioneer and took the standard from which space launches are handled today to a new height, while working fast between launches and without the bureaucracy that comes with a government-run operation. Just in the 2010s, we have been able to restart the space exploration, intensifying on the 2020s as we try to regain all that time lost between the 80s and the 2010s. Almost 30 years that we could have been asking ourselves, what could have happened? Or where could we be standing right now? The need to look for something outside of Earth orbit. All we have now is to strive forward and hope that the US government won't stand in the way again of human exploration and slow it down. Thanks so much for watching. Hope you liked this video. Make sure you to check my other videos, as I have a wide broad of themes I talk about in my channel. See you next time.